Hi everyone. So in this video, we will discuss how to move the block of data from location X to location Y without overlapping. Okay, so we have to move some of the data from some location X to some location Y without overlapping the data between source and the destination. Okay, so we shall start now. So first I will take the new file. Okay. So here, let us write the program for moving the data without overlapping. Okay, so first org 00h. Okay, so before I write the program, first I'll save this program. So do not forget to save the file using .asm extension. Okay, first I'll save the data, sorry, program. So now let us write the program. So org00h will start the program from 00 memory location. Then first I'll move some memory location to two pointers, because I need two pointer registers to point the data, right? So for that I will use two registers. For the two register, I'll move some addresses. Okay, let us say it is from 30h. okay, one location will start from 30h, that is the source location. Then other location will start from, let us say I'll use register r1, because these are the two registers I can use as a pointers. Okay, so r1, let us say this address will start from, say, 50h. okay, so first we will not use that address as a, or our data as address, so we have to move that as an immediate data to register r0 and r1. okay, now so what we'll do, so we will move, let us move this data to register r0 first. Okay, so register a first. Okay, so let's a comma, I'll write let r0. okay, this will, what it will do, it is an indirect addressing mode. So at r0, that means it will go to 30h address from there. So whatever the data is present, that will be moved to register a. Now from register a, I'll move this data to register r1, that is at r1 comma a. so this will move the data from register A to at R1. Okay, that means I want to move the data from 30H to 50H location. At R1 means, at R1 you have a 50H location. Whatever the data present in register A will be copied to R1. Okay, so now once I move the one byte of data, if I move from register R0 to R1, that means from 30H location to 50H, now I'll increment both the addresses. So that means I'll increment R0 as well as I'll increment one byte from R1. I'll also increase R1. Now both the address location will increment by 31H and 51H. Now again I have to repeat the same thing, right? I have to repeat the same instructions, right? First I have to move RA from A comma at R0, then I have to move at R0 R1 comma A. Same, I have to repeat it. So for how long? So based on how many bytes I want to forward or transfer from source location to destination location. Okay, so let us consider, so let us, I want to move some 5 blocks of data. Okay, 5 bytes of data I want to move from source location 30H to 50H. So what I'll do, I'll take a count. I need to have the counter to count, so how many times I have moved the data, right? For that I'll keep another counter. Let us say this is R3. Okay, so I'll move some data to R3. Let us say it is 05H. So this will count for 5 times. So how to count, how to keep a count of this? I'll use one more instruction, that is DJNZ. So this is decrement and jump if not zero. That means decrement to and jump, decrement the address or the counter and jump to the label if that counter is not zero. Here the counter I have kept as R3. Okay, if this R3 is not zero when it is decremented by 1, this will jump to the label. Here I'll use the label as back. So come back here. So I'll put the label here. Okay. This will use as like this. Okay. So this will what? So first it will decrement the R3 by 1. Now initially it is 5. It will decrement R3 by 1 means it will become 4. So now it will check whether R3 is 0 or not. Now R3 is not 0. So what it will do? It will jump to the label. So label is given here. So it will jump to here. The pointer will jump to here. Again, it will move the data from at R0 to register A. Now R0 is 31H. So whatever the data is present in the 31H will be moved to register A. From there, again it will move to at R1. That means at R1 means 51 location the data will be forwarded. Okay, this will repeat for 5 iterations. Then the program will should end. Okay, so if the R0 is R3 becomes 0, so immediately the program will end from its execution. Fine. This is the code for moving or transferring the block of data from source location to destination location, that too without overlapping between source and destination. So let us execute this instruction first. First I'll save this program, then I have to build for the errors. So I have not added this file to source group. So first I'll add this file to source group. So right click on the source group, add existing file. So I'll select test3. This is my file. So I'll add and close. Now I will save and build the program. Now executed the program. So no error found. Okay. So now I will go to debug. Then start and stop the debug session. So once you click on OK, now this will come to debug mode. Here 30H I have used as a source address for the data. That is, I want to move to destination address. So first I have to go to internal address. This is the internal memory address. Here I have to go to here to the source address location 30H. I will go here and select. So this is the address location. I will store 5 block of data, 5 bytes of data I will store from this location. This is 30, 31, 32, 33 and 34. Okay, so I'll store the data here. So how to store? Right click on the memory location, then click on modify at i30h location modify. We have to do it. So I'll click on this. Here I can give the data continuously. So let us give, 1h. I'll just give simple data. 1h, 2h, 3h, 4H and 5H. So if you want to store the data continuously in continuous memory location, you can give from the beginning only. Continuously you can give like this. Like example I have given, items can be, you know, entered like this. 1, 2, 3. Likewise you can enter it. Okay. So let us see. Let's click OK. Now the data is stored in the memory location, source memory location, from 30H to 34H. Now what we'll do? So we will move the data to 50H. So how do we do that? Let us execute step by step. Now I have to go to 50H. 50H my destination location, right? So this is my source destination location. I'll go to 50H. I'll go to 50. So here I will check. Okay, this is my destination address. After each instruction, I have to store the data here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5H should be stored in these locations. Let us check. So first move R0, 30H. It has moved to 30H. Then move R1 comma 50H, it has moved. So these two registers will be acted as a pointer registers. Then execute. So I have moved the counter value 05 because I want to move 5 bytes of data to destination location 50H. So now next instruction, move A comma at R0. So move A comma at R0 means at R0. So inside that whatever the data is present will be treated as address. 30H is my address. In the 30H, I have the first data, that is 01. So that has to move to register A. So it has come to register A. Here you can see. Right, from here, what they have given? So move at R1 comma A. So from register A, the data is to be stored to at R1. At R1 means R1 is pointing to 50H. So in the 50H, we have to store the data which is present in the register A. So this will store the data to 50H location. Here you can see the 50H location data storage. Right? Now from here, next I will increment R0, I will increment R1. So this will store the data from, so this will increment the register R0 and R1 by 1 byte. So this will become 31 and 51. Now again, this will decrement, DJNZ will decrement R3 by 1 and it will check the R3 whether it is 0 or not. If it is 0, it will end the execution. If it is not 0, this will jump to label back. Okay, so now we'll let's check. Now R3 is decremented by 1. Now R3 is 4. It will check R3 whether it is 0 or not. It is not 0, so it will jump back to the label. So it has jumped to the label. Again, same thing will repeat. Okay, now it has received 02, that will move to 51 location. Again, it will increment R0 and R1 by 1. Then again, it will check R3. So now R3 is 3. Again, it will repeat the same instruction. Okay, now I have got 03 at 51 location. Sorry, 52 location. Again, it will decrement R3. Now R3 is 2. Again, it will move the data to 53 location. Now the last step, so decrement R3 by 1, so it has moved the data to 05. Again it will decrement R3. Now R3 is 0, so it will end the execution. Okay, now we can see, so this will end the execution. Now I have moved the data from 30H memory location to 50H without overlapping. Fine, so this is the execution. So you can see here, so I have moved the data from 30H to 50H location. So this is the program for moving the block of data from source location, some source location, to destination location without overlapping the data between source and destination. Okay, so that's all.